Hello, Cornerstone. My name is Andrea Collet, and I've been attending Cornerstone for a number of years. I'm also a pediatrician.
And I'm Tiffani Dorn. I've been attending Cornerstone since 2011. I'm a physician assistant for 5 years.
We are a few of the medical professionals here at Cornerstone, and just wanted to share with you today some good information regarding COVID-19 and how you can help protect yourself, your family.
So what are the symptoms of COVID-19? Well, they're going to be very similar to symptoms of any other virus that you can get. First, the fever, 100.4 or above. Not everybody has a fever, but most people do. You might have a cough, you might get shortness of breath. Even after exertion, it might be a little bit harder to breathe with your normal activities. You're going to get some fatigue, maybe some runny nose, stuffy nose. New loss of taste or smell is kind of a unique one. You might have some gastrointestinal symptoms like diarrhea, nausea, vomiting. You might have a sore throat or headache, body aches, chills, or sweats. So we wanted to make sure that you know what you're looking for. If you have any of those symptoms, please just stay home. Don't go to church, don't go to work, don't go to the store, don't go to grandma's house, don't go see your neighbor, don't invite your best friend over. Just stay home. CDC recommends if you have any symptoms, you stay home for 10 days and don't reiterate back into public life or work or church for at least 72 hours after being symptom or fever free and having greatly improving symptoms during those times.
If you're having any of these symptoms, you may want to get some medical attention. It is nearly impossible to know whether you're having some other contagious disease versus COVID-19 without proper testing. So we encourage you, if you're having mild symptoms, to call your doctor or the hospital helpline to determine what your next step should be. In addition to that, there are possibly some very severe symptoms that can occur with COVID-19 that require immediate attention. And those things would include persistent pain or pressure in your chest, any trouble breathing, difficulty staying awake, new confusion, and definitely if you're seeing bluish lips or bluish coloration of the face, that is a severe symptom and that requires medical attention immediately. So let's move on to prevention. What can you do and what should you not do to protect yourself and your family from this virus or other contagious viruses?
Yeah, so number one, like we talked about, if you have any symptoms or anybody in your house has any symptoms, just stay home if you're not feeling well.
Secondly, wash your hands often. This is by far the best way to prevent any types of virus or bacteria entering your body. Washing your hands involves washing with soap and water for 20 to 30 seconds and using hand sanitizer if soap and water is not available.
Yeah, I carry this little guy around everywhere I go. Is this like free advertisement for my job? That's what it says. Next thing is you don't want to touch your face. If you wash your hands and don't touch your face, you're probably not going to get the virus.
The next step that we need to cover is protecting the medically vulnerable. This is really important. Elderly people, children, or adults with chronic medical conditions. So if you are caring for someone that is medically vulnerable, it is really important that you take all of the recommended steps. That may involve wearing a mask, washing your hands often, sanitizing the home.
When you cough or sneeze, make sure you do it into your elbow, do it into your sleeve, do it somewhere that's not gonna get on your hands or where other people are gonna touch or walk.
Next step is keeping your distance. We've all heard about social distancing, which means staying about 6 feet apart, which we are not doing so well.
I'm just gonna call out that awkwardness right now.
However, keeping your distance is important. It does help limit the spread of respiratory droplets if you're just staying away from other people. Finally, the mask. This can be a way to help prevent infection if it's used properly. So masks can prevent respiratory droplets from being spread from person to person. But it is paramount that you do it properly, otherwise it can do more harm than good. So we're gonna review a few do's and don'ts with the mask. Number one of the do's, use a clean mask. So if you have a cloth mask that you're having to reuse, make sure that it's clean. Secondly, Make sure that you're using clean hands when you apply the mask to your face. When you're putting on your mask, make sure that you're only touching the bands or the ties that you use to put the mask on and not the face covering. Make sure that when you're using your mask that you're covering your mouth and your nose, because respiratory spread comes from both the mouth and the nose. Make sure that you're wearing a well-fitted mask that's such that you don't have to keep readjusting it frequently, which would involve you touching the mask. Finally, when you're removing the mask, you should also use care to touch only the bands or the ties when you're taking it off. So the don'ts of wearing a mask. You don't want to touch the mask, especially the area that covers the mouth and nose. All of those germs that you're trying to keep from spreading to other people are now on your hands. If you're talking to someone, you want to leave the mask on at all times. If you need to eat or drink something, it's best if you completely remove the mask, wash your hands, eat or drink as you need to, and then replace the mask as we talked about.
So what are the recommendations for returning to church or school or work? First, you want to be fever-free for at least 3 days, that's a full 72 hours. Second, you want to have improving symptoms, no new symptoms. Third, you want to wait at least 10 days from the onset of your first symptom.
Finally, the take-home points. If you didn't listen to any other part of this segment, these are the things we want you to remember. Number one, wash your hands. Or use hand sanitizer if soap and water is not an option. Secondly, stay home if you're not feeling well or if you're not feeling normal. If you feel like you had to get into the medicine cabinet for something to help you feel better, you should not be going anywhere because you're not feeling well. Number three, don't touch your face. That includes if you're wearing the mask. Try not to touch your face. If you do, just wash your hands. And finally, if you're wearing a mask, put it on, leave it on, don't touch it until you need to remove it, and then wash your hands.
So we hope that was helpful just for you to learn a little bit more about the coronavirus, what to look for and how to prevent it. Thanks for watching and taking your time to learn more and keep each other protected.
Thank you.